Hi. First of all, I'm sorry for my English, not very best, but I will try to do an effort. I will talk today for the new Windows Service Bus ADI Labs April release. Oh, this is the actual name today. Maybe in the future, it will be Windows Azure BizTalk Service that we heard about in the product manager. So I'll do a quick introduction to the Microsoft integration stack, a quick overview of what we have today in the Windows Service Bus, and then we'll go talk about extensively with the new features of ANADI SDK Labs from April release. How can we get start developing, publish things in the cloud, and what you could expect in the next release of these features, okay? How many of you are developers here? Oh, nice, great. Okay, you already listened many things about Windows Service Bus BizTalk service. I may do a quick overview, and I will get in demos with Visual Studio in how can we really create a project from the scratch, okay? I'm feeling a little crazy today. Okay, so Microsoft Integration Stack, you all know the main product still BizTalk service, start in 2000, every 2 years a new release. In the next couple of months, it will be a new release from BizTalk server. In 2004, the product will take a revolution, creating new patterns, mapping, content-based routing, publish subscribing. Now is mainly new versions, new functionalities. I don't call a competitor, but another solution for integration, .NET, WCF, NapFabric, it's a good platform for integration problems. We have also Windows Azure Service Bus and other products like SQL Server Integration Service, SQL Master Data Service, SharePoint Connectivity Service, and so on to solve some integration problems, okay? This scenario, for many years, we are used to see these kind of scenarios. BizTalk work excellent in this type of scenarios. Many applications, many systems inside on-premise of your clients. We have to connect all of these systems. But now we have this cloud service. Many applications are shipped into the cloud. Many systems also to the cloud. So we have to have a decent way to making integration between cloud applications, system applications, both on cloud to cloud, or cloud to on-premise systems, okay? Cloud brings us some properties that are good for integration. Yeah, cloud is elastic, you can pay per use, you don't need to worry about some peak load of messages because you pay more, little. You can scale up, scale down, do that kind of scenarios in on-premise is complicated. It's not very easy to do. It's expensive. So if you buy some material and then you don't use it, it's expensive to have material that is not used. So cloud service brings some properties that are good for integration scenarios, okay? Service Bus, everybody knows, is a message infrastructure that allows applications to exchange messages in a flexible and scalable reasoned way. this is important, is maintained by Microsoft with an SLA of 99.9 monthly. It's basic always on, so it's very important. Service Bus also provides a relay and brokered message capabilities. Some of the difference, you can have a relay message pattern that supports one way, request response messaging or peer-to-peer messaging, or brokered messaging that provides durable asynchronous messaging components such as queues, topics, and subscriptions that allow us to create publish-subscribe scenarios, okay? Some of the difference between queues and topics, so you have applications that send messages to the cloud for queues. The backend is never overloaded with messaging because it takes his message and he processes the message at his own capabilities. It never overloads with traffic. We can improve performance and load balancing by creating new receivers, creating load balancing. But all receivers are competing for one messenger, and they get one copy of the messenger. The first get the message is processing the processed message, okay? The basic difference between topics, each receiver will get a copy of its own messages. See, if two receivers compete for the same message, the message will be sent for the two receivers, okay? So, this is a quick overview of Windows Azure Service Bus. It can solve problems from NAT problems, firewall problems. They can discover other applications and can make peer-to-peer connections. This way, you don't send message to the cloud. They communicate directly with one another. Okay, this is basically the overview of the infrastructure. But if you look careful, you only have some container of messaging. The process of the message transformation in other processment of the message are made by the receiver on premise or on application on the cloud. So a lot of power that you can use on the service bus is not used for this kind of operation, okay? So these new labs that Microsoft make available in April release, actually, it's not an official name yet, I believe. The right name for now is Windows Azure Service Bus AADI Labs. Others can call Windows Azure BizTalk Service. Others can hear like BizTalk as Platform as a Service. Okay. Actually, I don't know the official name yet. So this is a glimpse to the future. It's a CTP version. You can try for free. No problem. And it will. Oh, what happens? I press the end. Okay, instead of the next. Sorry. Okay. And this will bring common integration capabilities like transformations, business-to-business messaging, B2B messaging, to the cloud. This way, the processment of the cloud, validation, transformation of messaging, routing of messaging are made in the service bus on the cloud. And then you can connect, make integrations with cloud to cloud applications or cloud on-premise application in a very easy way, okay? They support two scenarios, basic capabilities. Until now, we have only routing functionalities. No? Now we have this word better pattern in the bridge is like, and if we make a comparison with BizTalk, like a pipeline, okay, it actually means validate, enrich, transform, enrich, and routing. Okay, we can do transformations on the cloud, and content-based routing. You have a connect log that allow us to connect with our internal systems. For now, there are five that you can connect. You can connect with the Microsoft SQL Server, Oracle Database, Oracle EB Suite, SAP, and Civil e-Business application. Okay. This is a common scenario. So you have different applications or different systems that will send message to a bridge on the cloud, on the service bus. They are processed in the cloud. You can make some validation, transformation, and then route to different system. Like you can put on the a web service, you can send it to a queue, or you can send it to your on-premise systems and connect with your internal, okay? The other capabilities, ADI capabilities. This will help you make interchange, messaging interchange with your partners, ADI. You already know, Edifact for us not support yet. I will open the future, next versions maybe. We'll support Edifact, but for now it's only X12 messaging. It's also available a portal with that we can create our profiles, our partners, and our agreements between them. So you can have a partner send you ADI message to ADI bridge, and then you can route them to basic HTTP binding, a bus topic, service bus queue, or for a bridge. Okay, so this will. When you send to a message to ADI bridge, they are your agreements between the partners. They made the transformation for a flat file ADI to XML. You can make some transformation there. And then you can send to different systems. You can pick up the message from FTP, or you can have also AS12 infrastructure. And then you can do batching processment. I will show a little more this feature, a quick overview, because it's X12. We are not used to see working X12, but you have an idea that what we will expect in the future for Edifact, okay? So after it's processed by ADI bridge, you can send to different systems, like a bridge, then again is transform, process, routing to maybe internal systems, okay? So, again, this is a story. This version is on the in CTP version. The first release was in December 2011, and the second was in April 2012. There are two portals available. This is not the Azure portal that is in production now. This is Lab App Fabric portal. So you can go there with your Lab ID, don't need any credit cards, and you can try these features, okay? Without paying anything. There's a forum also. If you have questions, you put that questions. MVPs or community members will help you, and also Microsoft members. The first version release all the basic capabilities that are available today: XML bridge, transformation, a way to connect with our internal systems, and also business to business messaging. April release brings you another features only, like flat file support, new mapping capabilities, ADI portal capabilities with more tracking, error messaging, and so on. FTP support and new encoding is supporting in this new release. Only new features, nothing really, really new. Next, I hope it'll be many difference. So how can we get start working with these functionalities? So you need Windows Server 2008 R2 or Windows 7, Visual Studio 2010, .NET Framework 4.0, C# .NET, SQL Server, App Fabric 1.0 or 1.1. I don't know if this in the future will be necessary. For now, it's necessary to have a Fabric, and ES 7 or higher. In Microsoft link that is available on the top. I hope these slides will be available for you guys to download, so then you get all of these links. You have available all what you need to install, Windows Service Bus AADI SDK, Service Bus Connect Setup, that will install also BStalk adapters there, in your machine. And you have a zip with all ADI schemas available, and then again two portals that you can create your namespace and create your partners. So this is what I intend to do, is all showing all of you in Visual Studio how you can easily do that, and maybe clarify some question that you have. Do I need to learn everything? I'm a BStalk developer. Do I need to learn everything from the scratch? It's be easy to upgrade to these kind of features. Do I need to buy a new developer to get this thing done to the cloud? So I hope this demo will clarify that questions. Okay. So let me switch my. Okay. I have a way to put this more. Nope. Okay. So first thing is portal app fabric. So I already get signed in because it's a little slow. Basic is, this is the old app Azure portal. We get in the bottle the app fabric, and what you need to do is create a new namespace. Mine is Sandra Azure AADI Bus, and that's it. You can write these features. Only need to sign and create a namespace. You will have here on the bottom, if I, your default issue, your default key that you need to deploy all the of things that you do in the Visual Studio. You need that key to deploy your solution to the cloud. So this is only the information that you need: namespace, owner, and default key. Okay. It's a little slow, I already told. Okay, there you go. Okay. So now I will create one very easy project. This is my first demo that I create. Is a scenario basically that we have a registration on event that we can send message to the cloud, and these messages will connect to my SQL on premise and put in a table. Okay, very easy way, very easy scenario. So Visual Studio. I have this annoying problem of my window. New project. And now we have, let me find where, this new type service bus. We actually have two type of project. The first thing is like create artifacts, but I really don't use this. This project, ADI project. The main one is integration application, enterprise application integration. So let's put a name, London event. And okay, that's our project. So in terms of experience working with Beanstalk, that's actually the same experience that I have in ServiceBus. So I have new item, I have a map, schema, flat file schema, and generate flat file schema. So I will create a schema. Oh, this is, don't worry. I change the root name. I'll create a record. Is unbounded. Minimum one. So pretty much the same experience. New element. Name. And other stuff. Okay. The same. So I have my input schema. Now I need to get my SQL schema, right? So we have this service bus explorer. I already create my new server. And we have the log system that we can connect. So I go to the SQL, add a new SQL target. We have to fill this wizard. My server is local, okay. I don't have instance. My catalog is my database. So let me get one. This is annoying because my window, okay. Catalog. Use Windows credentials, next. Then it's like the same experience that you have with SQL adapter in Beanstalk. So tables, person, we'll have an insert and say next. I fix my Windows credentials. Low level privilege. And next, I have to create a target. I have my target also create SQL, so I use my target create. I will create a new path called London event. So next, and create, finish. Okay, now I have MOP. Okay, now I have my web. Okay, this is it. I have my log that I create, I have to import my schemas to my project. So right click, add schemas to London Event project. I can give a prefix. I will put London Event. You'll create a folder for me called logs schemas. And I say, sure, okay, there's my schemas, okay? Very easy. So now we have to create a map to translate my input schema to my SQL schema. So add new item and create a map. So everything identical that we work with Bistalk. So, but here is really the difference. The map is completely different. So the interface look like the same. You can select the input and select the destination. So it's like the operations and the insert. Extend, same thing. But now you have this new functoids. I don't know if they call functoids, but like the same in Bistalk, or functions available. So one of the most uncommon functoid is the map each functoid. It's like a looping functoid, okay? It's very big. So, but once we drag this functoid, we can drag the name to one side to the other, and the links will get with the same context. So if I drag another, it's always in that context of the mapping functoid. You can drag some concatenate functoid inside, and then again the same experience that we have in mapping functoid, in mapping with Bistalk. And double click, we can add a separator, pretty much the same. So what's the limitation of this? We cannot use XSLT for now. We cannot use C-sharp, custom C-sharp for now. This will be available in the future, but for now it's not available. So, and in my experience, I'm not proud to say that, but I spent like 13 minutes to see how this works. Is to drag, and imagine that you have two records, and you have to drag two mapping functoids. So I tried to drag to the mapping, and nothing worked. So it only works inside of that. And I have to drag another two inside of that, don't work, only inside of that. Crazy. Yeah, because if you look, I'm with the scope activate, so if I close the scope, I say this is my context, I'm working in that context now. So if I drag a link to the other side, it gets linked to that context. If I close the two, I can drag is in general context, okay? So this is good because if you actually look to the looping functoid in Bistalk, you never know what type of links are in the context of the looping functoid. Now we know. It's very easy to read, okay? So but it's different, but then and again with a few hours practice it's very easy to implement mapping context with this new mapping, okay? So we have a input schema, we have an output schema, we have a mapping. Now we have to configure our bridge, okay? This is the bridge configuration. This is like Bistalk admin, when you create the port, put mapping, filter the context of the without orchestration, of course. Put some property promotion filter, and the send port. So I have my Bridget. This is a two-way request and response, okay? And I will drag my destination. So if you look at the toolbox, you don't see anything like SQL or Oracle. They aren't there, okay? You have to go to the Server Explorer. This is my London event, and drag. Okay, this is because my namespace is not configured. So I have to put Okay. Service space now is Sandra Azure. Sorry for the window. And now we can drag the London event to our bridge configuration. So there you go. My machine is okay, it's alive now. Many Visual Suits work in one machine. So now we have to link between the two. That's the configuration now. We have to configure the bridge. The AA bridge. Now you have what my type of message that is the input, so is persons. The response will be the SQL response. And I don't want to validate for now the mapping. I could enrich some property context of the message with to do some routing functionalities. This demo, I will show in another demo. And you will configure a mapping, the map. So the map is there, select. And okay. Good question. I don't know the answer because I don't never try this scenario, but I will try and give you an answer later. Okay? I have to try it. So we can make some transformation in the upcoming message. For now, I don't do that kind of transformation. So that's good. For now, my pipelines are configured. And now I have to set a filter condition. I can apply some filter based on some context. In this scenario, I say I want match all messages. I process all messages. Okay, that's it. Build, deploy, and it's working. Okay. I won't deploy this solution because I have my own solution. So already deployed because it takes a while to deploy everything to the cloud. So it, pretty much the same. I have my mapping that you can see with a great type of input schema, first name, last name. I do some concatenation of fields and transform to my SQL schema. So I have this tool to test. This tool is on CodePlex. You can download this tool to test your bridge. Normally we have two command line tools to test. I don't like command line, so I create this tool, me and my friend that is over there, Rui Machado. So you can configure your service bus namespace, your owner, and your issue key, and save, and then you can use all the default values without retype all over again. So if you look at my AppFabric portal, you don't see any artifact there. So the bridge is not there yet. The information that you want to see, I have this bridge, I have this schema, and so on, is not present in our portal. So the only way for now that I know is to actually go to my Visual Studio Bridge properties. And you have my target. This is the URL for my queue, my bridge, sorry. So I copy my, approximately the same. If I make a select in my table, you can see that there is none there. So I select a file, persons, you can see my XML file, enables, this is XML type, send a message, and maybe wait a little. It's working. I noticed that internet was a little slow, but it's sending the message to the cloud. I hope he's awake. Do I have internet? Let me see. Yes, I have, but very, very slow. No. Yeah. I believe this was like a timeout, but okay. It was a timeout problem, so. Internet's back online. Yeah, my first time at work. So, like in 10 minutes, you can have application on the cloud that make transformation and connect with your internal system, okay? So, the next scenario is like a order processor integration that you will send orders to the cloud. If it's a top priority order, we will again do put the message on SQL. If it's a normal message, we'll go to a queue on the Windows Azure. And if it's an invalid order, we'll send to another table of SQL, okay? Sorry if always SQL, but Oracle and SAP is not easy to have in the virtual machine. So, but then again, it's the same, okay? So I don't show you from the scratch, but we have our XML schema. Now, one thing that I don't say, but there are some limitations. If you, in this talk, we right-click on the schema and say test, generate instance, they're not available yet. But in the future, yes, we'll be there. So, but in for example, in the mapping, we can test the map.
Okay.
You can't be view the XSLT because this is not a SSLT map. Okay. This is different from Beanstalk. I don't know if SLAM. I don't know if the pronunciation is correct. So, but it's not. Mapping is completely different from Beanstalk. Okay. So we have our schema, our bridge configuration. This is important. So I get my custom order. I don't validate, but I will enrich the map with some property. So as you can see, we have a XPath property promotion. We have to copy the entire link from the schema, put identifier, say, okay, this is the message that I want to get the property, and say, put the name of the property that you want to give, and what type of type is the property, long, boolean. For now, we have only these four types, okay? And again, for quantity, the same. Pretty much the same, okay? So then I don't do anything more, just promote properties. I can do a mapping, and then after the mapping, promote again new properties from another schema, okay? So then I will put some conditions in the filter condition. So what I'm saying here is, okay, I only process this message if priority is equal to 100 and the quantity is more than zero, okay? Then we have the same for annoying. Normal order is not priority equal to saying. To 100, sorry, saying in Portuguese, and if invalid is quantity less than zero. I have another bridge there that do the transformation that I want. So if it's the top priority, I will transform this schema to a SQL schema to my table. If it's a normal, I will put in a queue that I'm already creating in the service bus, and if it's invalid order, I will use another mapping and I will put in another table. So let's see working. I have to select another type. Okay, top priority, edit. Shop. I'll put a different number because I already have this one. Say 7 as it, and I will send the message. Okay, I went 21, still waiting. Oh no, it's incorrect, so sorry. Now if I, the last one, okay, there you go. So
Oh, sorry. Select another type. I will put a normal order. I will send. Will be in the queue. If I go over here, I say my queue. Refresh. A little slow. What's that? Okay. So it's there. Okay. Just one more minute. Oh, sorry. Invalid. I will send. And that will be here. 22, okay? Everything work. So my last scenario, don't take many time, is so ADI portal. So it's a different portal, ADI App Fabric, also labs. This is basically create partners also in BizTalk administration console. We create our partner, we have to create our own partner and different partners. And then we create agreements between the partners, okay? So I already create one agreement. Okay, I will exchange message with client A. I have to set the qualifiers between them. Then this is the URL to my AIA bridge, ADI bridge. Then I need to define what type of message I will work. This is X12401840. Okay. I can select the transformation to transform ADI message to another type of messenger, and where I want to send the message that I receive. I will have these four types of endpoints for now. This is my scenario. I will send the message to another AIA bridge. Then I will put the message internally in my SQL on permits, okay? So the project, it's pretty much the same. I have the message. I have schemas that translate the different messages. This is my AIA bridge that I will send ADI message. The other bridge is configured in the portal. It's not in Visual Studio, okay? So I get this, my endpoint. I will select the message, ADI demo, ADI, as you can see, FAT file. So I'll send the text and I'll send. I have this tracking where I can see all the messages that is arriving and sent to the to others' systems. If any error occurs, you get the message, error message there. So, okay. That's my message is the first. You can see from the date time, I already sent the message and well, went well. You can view the details of the message here in my portal. We have also some resource that available here, my schemas. Okay. And if you can see ADI sales orders, I have the last one, will be my message, okay? So, back to the slides. What can we expect next? So, some type of orchestration or workflow, maybe it will appear in the next versions. The ability to create custom activities, maybe pipeline activities for validating, I don't know, and create custom code functoids. There are some functionalities like testing, generate instance for schemas and so on that will arrive in the next versions. Portal will be maybe upgraded to show the resource that we have on the cloud. I don't know if they will pack it in some kind of bespoke applications on the cloud, or it's like 2004, a big application with everything there. SLT will be supporting next release. Hybrid solutions will be some functionality for manage PowerShell scripts, manage the service that you have on cloud. I don't know if they will bring more log targets available. But they are improvement. Edifact, I don't know for when it will be arrived, but I hope. I don't know next version, but maybe the first official release will be available, I hope. Archiving, batching, trading will be upgraded. And that's it. I hope you enjoy. The experience is the same like working Beast Talk.